What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another Hot Leak What's Up Reaction. We're going to be jumping into something kind of cool, a new Aurora interview with Triple J. Hey, if at any time you decide you like the interview, definitely go over and show Triple J some love on their channel. I'm going to leave it down below. Aurora interview, carrots, picnicking, castles, bass, and runaway. That's a lot of different topics. We only got 13 minutes, so that's a short amount of time to discuss that many topics. Let's go. Warriors and Weirdos, welcome back. I do appreciate you being here. Let's go.
Welcome back to Triple J.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.
How are you? I saw on TikTok a couple of days ago that you were hiding in a forest. Are you still hiding in a forest?
No, not at the moment, but I have been hiding for quite some time. And I've just been, you know, talking with the squirrels and how.
Leave it to Aurora to be hiding of all places in the forest and talking to the squirrels. If that doesn't just add to the whole fairy tale esqueness that is her, the magicness that is her, the forest dwelling magic creature that is her, I'm saying.
Quite some time. And I've just been, you know, talking with the squirrels and hugging the trees and doing all of those things. It's been very lovely. And I've also had a lot of wine. It's been a very good combination between like healing and poison. But now I'm back.
It's a great combination of healing and poison.
Mainland.
I feel like the only time I've ever talked to squirrels has also been after some wine.
Yes, of course.
Apart from music, how have you been entertaining yourself recently, Aurora?
Oh, well, the same things as always. I am very good at entertaining myself. I find myself very entertaining. I've just been painting and existing in my home, eating a lot of food, a lot of delicious food, and drying things. I've become an expert, if I must say.
An expert at drying things?
Like what, drying what sorts of things?
How
like
does one become a drying expert?
Yes, both flowers, fruit, and
oh, okay,
bugs.
Drying things and, out. Got
very,
it.
Yes, I'm very good at it. So that's been a very splendid hobby.
Is that a hobby that you learned as a kid or something, or is just something you've just learned recently?
Well, I feel like it's a thing I've always known deep in my heart. drying things.
I just put them in the sun, hard to admit, yeah.
Yes. I started doing it lately.
All right.
It's a new hobby.
Yeah, I'm always impressed with every time I check in with your socials or anything, that how your ability to not only entertain yourself but also find joy in small things. No, I the other day I saw you were just talking about how much you loved carrots.
Yes.
And I was just like, that's so great.
I love them.
Like, what
I
do you love about?
I dressed up like one today.
You actually have. What do you love about carrots so much?
Well, obviously, besides the fact that they're orange.
But they're not, Aurora. We've just been told that they're orange. The Dutch made them orange.
You know, I love the sound they make. And I love their.
That was an incredible carrot.
That was an amazing carrot
People
crunch.
People listening at home would not be able to know this, but you don't have a carrot. You just did that with your mouth. That was really impressive.
One of my many mouth talents. I just love carrots. They're fresh, and there is something about them that never fails to cheer me up. Yes,
that's beautiful. But onto music. Apart from obviously drawing bugs, hugging trees, chatting to squirrels, all amazing stuff. And we could talk about those forever, frankly. Mm-hmm. But there is a new song called Give In to the Love, which we're going to put on in just a second.
Yes.
Can you tell us a bit about where this started for you?
Well, I was thinking one day, as you do, you know.
as you do, yes.
About what is it called again? You know, the third Alien movie. What is it called?
Prometheus?
Yes, thank you. I was thinking about Prometheus. Not
the movie or the myth?
The myth.
Okay.
Because I'm very interested in mythology. I just think it's the most fantastic thing ever.
Absolutely.
And I was thinking about Prometheus and how he supposedly made mankind in clay and how he stole the fire from the gods to kind of make us alive and complete us, I guess. And I was thinking about this clay and how much we obsess with the looks of this clay that kind of means nothing, and how it seems to distract us from the value of, I guess, the fire that we keep inside.
That is one of the most brilliant things that I've ever heard. We think too much about the clay and not enough about the magic that's making the clay come to life. Too many people are focused on how the clay looks. Stop worrying about it. Stop focusing on it. Stop letting society tell you to focus on it. You know, the worst thing about all of these makeup tutorials and things like that online is that they make people feel ugly. That's the only real thing that I have against them. At the end of the day, there's somebody at home thinking, watching those, thinking, I wish I could look prettier. And I hate that. I hate that people are so caught up in how they look. Personally, I like myself a natural, beautiful woman. Like, leave that. If you need to paint yourself like a clown, there's no need for it. There's no need for all of that. Be natural. Be you. Just be. Most of the beauty comes from that fire inside anyway. We know this.
And that's very sad. I think
it's tragic.
The world today makes a lot of people very unhappy because we obsess with these strange things, like how we look. So many people base their whole worth on how they look, and they never feel like they look beautiful enough. And I find this obsession with beauty both very fascinating and very scary at the same time. So it's kind of about that. I guess clay, no. Fire, yes.
Wonderful.
A perfect assessment.
Rory, you were just saying that song was kind of inspired by the myth of Prometheus. You were saying stole fire from the gods to give to mankind. Have you ever stolen something? Are you much of a thief?
I guess I have. I've enjoyed a bit of like picnicking my whole life. I love
picnicking.
I love stealing flowers from other people's gardens.
Did you say picnicking? What's picnicking?
Oh, is it not a word?
I thought
it was like your word. You did this.
nitpicking.
I don't want to. Frankly, it's adorable. So I would love to take responsibility for it, but I don't know if that is ours. Nitpicking? No.
Okay. Picnicking?
Picnicking.
Nitpicking.
Lip picking.
If I was to define nitpicking, I would say it's about like stealing one of each, not a lot. Not like a bunch.
Okay.
But you steal one thing.
Okay.
Like stealing one gum, one child, one flower. It's like a tiny.
One gum, one child, one flower.
Yeah, because nitpicking is a word, but it doesn't mean that. But frankly,
I think you just took it over.
A better definition. Yeah.
Aurora, just own that word.
And tell them it should become a word.
We're adding an adorable new crime, police. you've also been, you've had such.
I love how genuine she is. When she laughs, you know that she's like, she legitimately is having a good time right now.
Wild few years of like things blowing up, including it's often interesting when a song finds a new life on TikTok, and your song Runaway has found a life on TikTok. this part in particular, people on TikTok might recognize it.
And I was running far away, would I run off the wall someday? Nobody knows.
To have half a million people making videos with this song around the world must have been so incredible. Were there any that stood out to you?
I think all the videos that I could see were made like from countries on the other side of the world hit me in quite a magical way. And I was very moved, I guess, by people allowing my song into their hearts during, I know it was a hard time when that song kind of lived its best teenage life out there.
I felt she just got such a unique way of seeing the world and describing things that are going through her mind.
Lived its best teenage life out there. I felt like people maybe needed a song like that, which is very touching. And very like, it's very brave to let anything in, into your heart and touch it. So I felt very touched by it. But yeah, it was nice also to see people kind of uniting during, you know, during such a separated time, and seeing them keep themselves busy with this trend thing, isolated in their rooms. It's a very touching thing.
I will say that for TikTok, it has inspired a lot of people. It has been a time passer for a lot of people. It has built a lot of people's confidence. The people that are willing to put themselves out there on TikTok, whether it's doing some silly little dance, whether it's doing some silly little prank or a voiceover, it doesn't matter. Like, people are learning to put themselves out there. They're learning to brand themselves. And that's something that I think is 100% healthy. Brand yourself. Show the world who you are and put a stamp on it and put a value on it.
But also, it's very absurd. So I also kind of don't care so much.
There's just such a different, there's just such a wide array of different types of TikToks people have made involving it. Sometimes people are doing acrobatics. Sometimes they're just, you know, I'm singing in their room. I saw one man walking his pet tiger to the song in a beautiful, wonderful backdrop. There's just, there's a lot going on with that song. And it feels like, I guess if you write a song, there's no way you could imagine that it could mean so many different things to so many different people.
Oh no, not at all. And I wrote this when I was like 11. I was so young then. I didn't even know what nitpicking meant. No, I was very young.
Oh my God.
It was very surreal. But I guess it makes sense also, because whatever comes from an authentic place on the inside will hit authentic places on the outside for other people. Or I guess, you know, it just makes sense, like in the balance of the universe and the whole existence of everything.
That's a very beautiful way of seeing it.
Well, obviously that's a very old song still doing well, and now there's this brand new one. But are you working on an album at the moment, Aurora?
Yes, sir, I am indeed. I have been working on an album, as we all have, I think. I think every single artist have, because we have. But it's, yes, I have, and it's been wonderful. I rented this, or like, I stayed in a little castle here in Norway for like a month, and I just made the whole thing. It was very... a very nice thing. Also, a lot of wine and squirrels included, in a completely platonic way, of course. Not misunderstand. But yes, I
don't get it twisted.
Yes, it was really, it was a beautiful adventure, and I made this album asking a lot of questions, I think. Not really claiming that I have any answers, but I'm asking a lot of, I think, important questions about, you know, this one little tiny life we have been given, and whether we spend it in the right way.
Did you, when you're making an album in a castle, did you know anything about the castle or the history of it before you booked it? Do you know what happened there, or was it a famous castle? I know nothing about anything, so I don't know anything about castles.
Nothing about anything?
Well, sorry. with regards to Norwegian castles, sorry. Yes.
Oh, okay, that's fine. That's much better. Well, it is a very small castle, and I kind of know the people that keep it, like, keep it warm, I guess. Yes,
and the people that keep the castle warm.
And I was allowed to stay there. I asked them, and they said yes. They said I do, and it was just lovely. It's like you have to jump on a boat, or you can technically walk, of course. But I like to jump because there's a little space between like land and the boat. So I jump on the boat, and it takes 2 hours, and then you arrive in this beautiful little place called Rosendale, And there are many like huge mountains there.
You can tell that Triple J 100% thinks that she is as magical as I think she is. Like, they're just so engrossed in it. They're all smiles as well. This is a great, great interview. Just completely like random spontaneity. I love it, especially when it's coming from Aurora.
It's called Rosendale. And there are many like huge mountains there. And they all kind of bend over the little village like they're kind of taking care of it. And the castle is like 500 years old, 400 years old, 400. And it was owned a long, long time ago by a French baron who was very interested in arts and the healing, you know, possibilities of music. So that's why I went there. It just felt right.
Wow. Are they good acoustics in a castle?
Yes.
Yeah. All right. Good to know. Because we're obviously working on our album as well.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we'll have to find a castle here in Australia to record it in, undoubtedly.
Yeah.
I think there's like a macadamia castle in the northern New South Wales. Yeah, we'll look into it. Yeah.
Look into it.
But Aurora, you're also doing a huge tour around Europe next year. Do you have any thoughts about maybe being able to come to Australia if things are allowed in next year?
Well, yes, I hope. I love being in Australia. I always feel so alive there. And I love the bats. And I also love the people. You're so freaking friendly. And it's so nice.
It's telling
so
though
nice.
That you love,
I love Australia.
When you were listing the things you love, it went bats first and then people. So, you know, it's...
Yes, it would be weird otherwise.
Are there no bats in Norway?
We have them, I think, but they're very small and they're not as impressive. Like, they have no confidence.
The bats in Norway have no confidence. There's that laugh from Triple J. Amazing.
Bats. The poor bats in Norway.
They have very arrogant bats.
Might be the greatest interview ever.
Hopefully we will get to see you in the country really soon. Yeah, we'd love to hear more from this album as well. For the meantime, Aurora, such a pleasure as always. We'll chat to you again soon.
Yes, thank you so much for having me. Bless you all.
There you have it, ladies and gentlemen. Aurora interview, Carrots picnicking, Castles, Bats, and Runaway. Over on Triple J, most certainly a freaking epic interview. If you guys enjoyed it, go show Triple J some love on their channel. Go show Aurora some love on her channel. I'm going to leave them all down inside the description. Hit the like button if you liked it, the dislike button if you disliked it. Check out one of my other videos up there. Subscribe right here if you want to see more content, possibly your content. Until the next one, I'm highly combustible. You guys be happy, healthy, safe, and love you to the moon and back. Peace.